Today we're going to talk a little bit about CCWing with injuries and disabilities. I'm obviously in the situation, so let's get started. What's up, America? This is Neil from Jago Farms Academy. Thanks for watching. Today, of course, we're going to talk about injuries and disabilities, and we're going to probably turn this into a series just so you guys know. There's been a lot of requests on all our different medias for this type of stuff. We're definitely going to be doing from a wheelchair coming up here on our Patreon channel. So if you like this one, go check us out on that one. But again, we're going to continue the series. So let's just talk a little bit. Obviously, I've had, for those that haven't been following, I've had rotator cuff surgery. And so I have no use of this arm. Literally, I can hold a cup of coffee and that's about it. And in the meantime, I'm obviously in this apparatus. This is a new tactical sling, which is going to be offered by Jago Farms. No, I'm kidding. This is a sling that keeps this all put together. So a couple things that we need to understand. There's a lot more that goes into this now that I have to think about that I could have taken for granted or just ruled out entirely. So that, number one, I only obviously have one hand, which changes everything. It changes how my gun is actually set up, which I'll show you in a second, but also gear. It is pointless to carry anything anymore in a right pocket. This pocket is useless to me. Might as well not exist because there's no way I can really access anything here. Let's talk about the sling. And it's actually, it can be an aid because now it gives me an opportunity to carry things in a way that I really couldn't carry without this because this covers up a lot of things. So it is also in a way an advantage, and we'll talk about that. But let's talk about my firearm itself. So I obviously carry back here in the, what is this? What's the opposite of 4 o'clock, whatever that is for lefties now.
9 o'clock.
Kim says 9 o'clock. Okay, so 9 o'clock back here. So now when I go to access my gun, same rules apply, drag my thumb down, grab my pistol, and out we go. The pistol itself, though, good point to talk about, is I have the M&P 2.0 compact, and so the magazine release, which used to be on this side for my right hand, I had to switch over, okay? Very simple process to do, just moving a little bar in there, but it's something I have to set up so that if I ever have to manipulate this, I can. Most importantly, can you actually do it, right? If you don't have a ton of experience with using your offhand or your sport hand, now's the time to dry fire and figure stuff out if you're in that situation, right? So I got to be able to drop my magazine out. I need to have a way to reload my magazines. And I'm also going to do another one where we're going to walk through the mechanics of actually manipulating the gun one-handed. In my case, it's going to be one-handed weak side, so that's the or support hand, rather. And so we're going to talk about that in an upcoming video. But I had to switch that over. Let me go ahead and try to reholster this. Okay, so now let's talk also my EDC stuff. So I always carry my flashlight here and my knife, which obviously is now going to always be in my left pocket until I have use of my right arm. The knife itself, the way your pocket clip is set up, so that you can actually access this knife and use it effectively. You know, you're going to probably have to switch what side that is because of the way that the knife sits in the pocket now. It's going to be the opposite direction. So that's something that you're going to have to practice with and figure out, okay, this doesn't feel natural anymore because the clip is on the opposite side as it should be. So we've got to pay attention to changing those things and being able to still manipulate everything just as we would with our strong hand, okay? I'm always a big fan of working your support hand as much as you can, okay? So let's talk about the sling and how it can be an aid. For those that follow me, you know I'm a big fan of knives and how effective this tool can be, especially a fixed blade knife. I don't think there is a weapon on the planet that can be deployed faster than that, unless it's already in your hand, from concealment. And it's extremely effective, far more than a firearm at close range. Now, what can we do with this? Well, for one example, you could take paracord, run a loop that will be fit for your going around your elbow here, and then you can tuck this whole unit inside here, so the paracord will hold it in there. My hand goes over the handle, and now I carry this knife very, very quick and fast to get in there and access this weapon, and if I had to use it faster than my gun or anything else. And it's actually aided by having this cast on there. I mean, having this sling on there. So just because we have a sling on there, don't necessarily mean that we can't use it for an advantage. I typically carry this on the belt line. That would still work fine. Down here, whatever orientation you want to do it, but big fan of a fixed blade knife, especially in a situation. Now, let's talk about the sling and how it's going to affect my clothing, for example. Right now, we're in the Northeast Ohio, so right now There's literally snow that is as high as my waist in unplowed areas. So we're wearing Carhartts and heavy jackets, and we can pretty much conceal anything we want very easily. That said, we still got to be aware of how this is a sling, for example. You'll notice that down here there's a buckle, okay? And that buckle, which helps me out quite a bit to keep everything tight against my body, is for this strap. Ah, now what does that pose? Well, as you can see, this causes a little bit of a problem here because it's basically like a belt around my stomach, and my gun is here, and so it's kind of wonky how this is all set up. So I got to be aware before I leave and go out, if I'm going to wear, and right now I basically wear my coat halfway, right? I run it through my sleeve and then just kind of pull it over. Trying to clear all this out of the way with only one hand, not the smartest idea. So what I'm going to do is take my inner shirt here, whatever that may be, and I'm going to tuck it behind the gun, okay? So it's clear here. So once I move that Carhartt or whatever, you know, jacket out of the way, then I can go ahead and access my weapon system. And it's just a matter of pulling it over when I do that, and then I'm going to disconnect if I'm going to go, like, sit down and eat somewhere, or I look more normal if I'm not going to be wearing my coat, okay? And then I'll just take the strap and hold it up there. But that strap could be a big problem if you don't think through that. It's going to jam everything up. Now, mindset, which is what I'm telling you guys is most important than anything, is really, really important now, more so than ever before. Obviously, I'm at a disadvantage. I'm still a pretty big guy and still with one hand and my system set up, I'm still pretty effective. But at the end of the day, I'm at a disadvantage as I would be with two hands and like I normally am. And so whatever our scenario is, whatever the situation is, this is extremely important that we're getting as much advance intel, if you will, advance notice of bad things happening. And the only way we're going to be doing that is by being very vigilant, being very aware and alerted to our surroundings. So whatever your normal level of alertness is, and hopefully it's at a level where you're still paying attention to things, I am up onto another level above that now, okay? It's critical, especially this side. I have very little that I can do on this side, so I always want to position myself. Just walking around, I don't want anyone bumping my arm right now. That would be very painful. And so I'm always aware, hyper aware, I would, sensitive of areas over here specifically, okay? But we want to be as aware of the situation as we can. And the whole point of this, at the end of the day, even though I only have use of one hand, has that changed me carrying a gun? No, it has not. Do I still carry the same EDC stuff? Yes, I do. If I wanted to throw a magazine in here, I could. I would honestly probably take another magazine and put it somewhere in the sling where I can pull it out that way, because that gun is going to have to be in a position where I can hold it and then put another magazine if I have to. But again, we'll do a video specifically on mechanics. But the point is, I want to have my proper mindset and be aware of my surroundings. And that is a direct carryover to any situation, injury or disability. Maybe you don't have use of an arm permanently, or you're in a wheelchair, or whatever, you don't have a leg, or whatever the case is, that situational awareness, that higher level alert is covering all those factors. We have to be aware because we're at a disadvantage. It could be that you're just up in years and maybe your hips are not good anymore and you don't have the mobility or the strength. Again, being more aware than the average person is critically important in that case. The last thing is, guys, you don't want to end up in a situation like this. I was obviously injured, and this can happen to anybody. You can slip and fall and break your arm. And if you haven't previously trained to be proficient with your support hand, that's a bad time to have to figure that out. That's a bad time to have to train. Take advantage now. If you have the ability, you're not injured, work that support hand. Work using that, whatever that hand may be, right? We want to work through that and get those skills down so that, God forbid, something should happen, we're prepared, okay? I mean, I would be in a real bad situation when I got to get my shoulder healed and then try to figure out how to learn a whole manipulation of the gun and stuff. If I never did that, that'd be a big deal. So I'm so glad that I'm an instructor and I do these things on a regular basis. This definitely given me a major advantage, and now it shows through. All right, guys, I hope you learned something from this. Again, we're going to probably turn this into a series. We're going to hit wheelchairs for sure on our Patreon channel. So that's going to be coming out real soon. And maybe some other disabilities, other leg issues and things like that, limited mobility, those types of things. If you like this, please go ahead and give me a thumbs up. I always appreciate that. Go ahead and subscribe if you haven't before. If you guys aren't being notified that we're getting videos out, make sure you click the bell next to the subscribe button and you'll be notified when we put videos out. You can find us on Instagram, Patreon, That's where A-level stuff goes, YouTube, and Facebook. Until next time, remember, it's always better to be judged by 12 than carried by 6.